Do you charge different prices to different customers for the very same merchandise that you sell? Well, in that case, you should learn about QuickBooks price levels. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Why do we use price levels? Well, sometimes we charge different prices than what we would normally charge for specific items that we sell. These special price rules are usually based on the specific customer that we sell them to. For example, if we sold apples to an apple pie company that made apple pies for the homeless, we would then charge them a different rate from the apples as compared to what we would charge our normal customers. So how do we set up for price levels? Well, the price level list will let us choose which products or services we will make special prices for. These special prices will then be assigned to specific customers. When we sell these items to that customer, the special price will appear instead of the normal price. For example, we have a new customer called Anna's Amnesty Apple Pies. It's a not-for-profit organization that helps people by giving them apple pies. You know, we have to play along. It's kind of hard to think of these examples. We will sell apples to her for $40 per apple crate instead of the normal $50 per apple crate. First, we have to add the special prices to the price level list. From the main menu, click List, Price Level List. Now, like with any other list in QuickBooks, we click the bottom left and click New. The name of this price level will be Apples Homeless. Just so that we remember, oops, excuse me, just so that we remember what it is, spelling really doesn't count. Now, we click in the left margin of the specific item that we are making a custom price for. Then on the right, we type in the special price that we will give to specific customers. Push Tab. Now, notice on this row, in addition to showing the standard price, it also shows you your purchase cost so that you don't make the custom price too low. Now, this is a little strange. When you click OK, you have to click No because if you click Adjust, it'll flip back to the original price. So for some reason, you have to click No. And to double-check that it saved it properly, you could double-click right on it and make sure that it saved the $40 custom price. It's a little tricky. Just click OK. Now that you have the price on the price level list, now you have to assign the price to the customer from the customer center. So at the moment we add Anna's Amnesty Apple Pies, we have to also add the special price that she gets for apples. From the main menu, click Customer, Customer Center. Then in the top left, click New, New Customer. Now the name is Anna's Pies. You don't have to type in the whole name. This is just for example. But notice in the new customer window, which is the same as the edit customer window if you come back to it, there are five tabs. You have to click Payment Settings tab on the left, go to the pull-down on the right, and choose the specific custom price level that applies to this specific customer. Then click OK, and now we're ready to sell Anna apples at a special price. So, let's imagine on June 1, 2019, We sold 10 apples to Anna for cash today. Well, cash today means we made a sale receipt, and the date that we sold it to her is June 1 of 2019, and the customer is Anna's Pies, and the item that we sell her is apples. Aha! Notice $40 automatically came up instead of $50, and we're selling 10 of them, so 10 at the special price would be $400. Now keep in mind, the cost of goods sold is still going to be $100 because we paid $100 for the apples that we're selling to Anna for $400. And the sales will increase by $400. Save and close. And if we open the trial balance, we can see when we look at sales, double click, scroll to the very bottom, the last sale actually got recorded as $400 in income. But if you double click the cost of goods sold and go down to the very last sale here on June 1, the cost of goods sold is still, or it's actually a little different, it's $105.36 because it's $10.54 is really the cost of each pie. But you get the idea, and that's how you set up and manage price levels. And now you will see an example where we give a percent reduction to a particular customer. And in this example, we will also apply the price levels to services rather than merchandise items. So this will help you learn. Let's imagine that we now give Betty a 20% discount on editing and video services. First, we have to add the special prices to the price level list. From the main menu, we click List, Price Level List, and in the bottom left, click Price Level New. Now, we will type Betty's discount because she is a very good customer. We will click the check marks on the two services that we give the special prices to. That will tell you and indicate to you that we give price levels on services as well as products. We want it to be 20% lower than the normal price. But now this is a little different. We will click Adjust, which is different from what we did when we typed in a specific price. So again, if it's a percent, we click Adjust, then click OK. Now we're ready to perform. Now we're ready to assign the price level to Betty. So we set it up in the list. Now we have to tell QuickBooks that Betty is the one who gets this discount. We click Customer, Customer Center, and we double click on Betty to get the Edit Customer window. Remember, the correct tab is the Payment Settings, and go all the way to the right. The pull-down menu choice allows us to choose Betty's discount, that particular price level, and click OK. Now we're able to sell her those services, and her prices will come up. So let's imagine on June 3rd, we did 1 hour of video and 1 hour of editing for Betty. So we open the sale receipt, and we put the date June 3rd, and we choose Betty. Notice what happens when we choose editing. $140 did not come up. She got a 20% reduction. We choose video. $300 did not come up. She got a 20% reduction because she is Betty. Save and close. And that's how you create and assign and use price levels.